Hello everyone, and today we're going back to my home country, the Netherlands, for some old classic apple pie. For the apple pie, we need apples, preferably Granny Smith, flour, sugar, cold unsalted butter, egg, a bit of vanilla flavoring, cinnamon, and custard powder. And then for the cream, we need egg, milk, sugar, flour, vanilla flavoring, and custard powder as well. If you don't have custard powder or vanilla flavoring, don't worry, this is completely optional. So first we are going to make the cream. For this we need 500 ml of full milk, which we are going to heat slowly on a pot. And then we're going to get 4 separated eggs. We are only going to use the egg yellow, so please save the egg white for a meal later on. Add some vanilla flavoring. Mix this all together till it slowly becomes lighter in color. Then add 25 gram of flour and 60 gram of sugar. If you want, you can also add a tablespoon of custard powder to the mix. Then mix this all together till it gets a very thick substance. Now that the milk is warm, add the warm hot milk for half of it to the mixture. Mix this all together till it gets all mixed up. Then add this to the rest of the milk on the fire. And then it's time for mixing, and mixing on low heat. You will mix for 8 till 10 minutes. So yeah, don't get bored. Just mix it till it gets as a very thick cream. When it's thick enough, after 8 or 10 minutes, get it off the fire and let it cool down to room temperature. You might even want to put it in the fridge later on. For the dough, we need 300 gram of flour, 150 gram of sugar, and then mix this a bit together. Now it's time to get one egg and beat it together. When the egg is beaten, first add 100 gram of cold unsalted butter to your flour mixture. Mix it together, then add another 75 gram of cold unsalted butter to the mixture. Add the egg, and now it's time to make your hands dirty. Mix the butter, the egg, the flour and the sugar mixture all together with your hands. Keep kneading and kneading, and in the end you will end up with a nice round dough ball. If the dough ball is too wet, add some extra flour, and if it's too dry and it's falling apart, then add some more butter to it. Now that your dough ball is ready, put it in the fridge for at least 15 minutes for resting. So now we're waiting for the dough to get ready. Let me tell you a short history about the Dutch apple pie. The first Dutch apple pie probably dates back to 1514 and can be found in the cookbook Notabel Boeken van Kokkerijen. It was quite different to the one we know today. The apples were baked under a thick layer of pastry, and after baking, some of this layer was removed and the hot apple pie filling was mixed with crumbled suikerkoeken or sugar cookies. By the 17th century, the Dutch cookbook De Verstandige Kok features 6 different recipes for apple pies. Apple pies were not only found in recipes, painting also attests to the appreciation of apples back in the Golden Age. However, all those apple pies are different from the apple pies we know nowadays, and every Dutch person might have a different one, and I'm pretty sure that they will tell you that their grandmother's one is the best one. Now it's time to get the 6 apples ready. Remove the skin from the apples, cut them in half, cut them another time in half, remove the inside from it, peel them in small blocks, and do this till all the apples are in small chunks in a pan. Now add a little bit of vanilla flavoring if you want, and of course cinnamon powder. Mix this together, and if you want, you can even add some custard powder to it as well. Make sure this whole mixture is mixed together. The only thing that's remaining is the covering. For this we need 70 gram of flour, 70 gram of sugar, and 70 gram of butter. Mix this together. If you do this with a fork, this will crumble, and those crumbles, that's the one we needed on top of the apple pie later on. And now it's time to preheat the oven 175 degrees Celsius. Also, make sure you grease a tin and put some flour around it as well before we're going to put our dough inside. Get the dough out of the fridge, roll it flat. Make sure you roll it as flat as that you want for the cover, but at least make sure it's enough to cover the bottom and also the sides of your tin. Yeah, I speed up this process a bit. It can take a while, but yeah, just stick it around the tin and you will have a cover. Then add the cream to it. Make sure it's evenly distributed. Add the apple blocks to it. And when that is done, you only need to add the crumbles. When this is all covered, put it in the oven for 45 minutes. After 45 minutes, check if the apple pie gets golden brown on top and cover it with some foil. put it then back in the oven for another 15 minutes and then take it out of the oven and you can enjoy a delicious Dutch apple pie.